Hey folks, Matt Easton here, Scholar Gladiator, and I have Valerie here, also Scholar Gladiator. And so I want to look at a little thing, and this is to do with how to deal in a lunge-based system. So I'll talk a bit about that in a second. In a lunge-based system against someone who always retreats with their defences, something you could do against them. Now, if you're an experienced fencer, you will know this, okay? But I know that lots of people watching these videos aren't experienced fencers, so you might find it interesting, you might find it useful. Should also point out, one of the cardinal sins of people in fencing is to retreat when they defend, okay? It's one of the problems, it's particularly true, generally speaking, when people are relatively new to it, because they don't trust their guard, they don't trust their parry, they'll tend to move backwards at the same time. The reason you don't want to do this is because ideally, Valerie, if you go out there and give me an attack with a lunge, that's number one, if you stand in distance and don't move and defend, the person attacking you is now in distance to be riposted, okay? They're now in distance to be hit back. If when I defended, I moved backwards, I now can't reach them unless I now put my foot in. Okay, so what we're doing is we're trying to minimize the amount of shuffling around and foot movement we do. We're letting the attacker, we're reeling them in like a fish, letting them come into distance, so we can simply go guard the post. Okay, so stop and counter. And if we move backwards, they're not going to be within distance to be hit by that riposte so quickly. Now, very commonly, Valerie, if you do the thing which is not correct, when I give you an attack, so I'm going to give you a number one, you've got a cart guard in, inside guard, and move backwards at the same time. Okay? So one of the frustrating things is when you're fencing some people and you want to either do a feint and then hit them or just try and hit them with a single hit, they always move away too far. And so, for example, if I'm here and what I'm intending to do is feint number one, so you guard it and move backwards, and then I want to hit them with a real attack here, they're too far away. Okay? If Valerie didn't move away, and I feint hit, I can now reach her. So that's good for me, she stayed where she was. But you might think, okay, well that's great for Valerie because if she moves away, she doesn't get hit. Yes, that's kind of true, but it also means she can't hit me back. Okay, so it's kind of bad for both of us because if she moves away, she can't riposte effectively, and if she moves away, equally I can't hit her. Okay, if you know that the other person is better than you, by all means move away, run away if you possibly can, okay, run as far away as you possibly can. But if you want to win the fight, you have to hit the other person back, and if you want to hit the other person back, you need to stand your ground at some point, or even close ground. So, if you're with an opponent that you want to hit, and every time you throw a cut at them, they move away, okay, that means you can't even set them up for a feint, because you'll go feint, they'll move away, and you'll do a real attack and be far away. So, too far away. So, how do you get over that? Well, this is the way. First of all, look at my feet. I'm going to move a bit further away so you can see my feet. There we go. So, instead of making your either feint and real attack, or direct real attack with a lunge, what we're going to do is we're going to take the back foot, bring it up to the front foot, and then you're going to do your thing. Okay, so your attack would look somewhat like this. So, as you launch the attack, back foot comes up. So you take the arm and attack it. So back foot comes up to my front foot, and then I spring forward and do the attack. Okay, so you can move back into the defensive side. Okay, now even though Valerie has defended, you can see that I'm now still in distance to hit her. Because the shuffle, if I get back into distance to see my feet again, the shuffle backwards that a person usually makes when they defend is about the same as you gain by bringing the back foot up level with the front one before you do your lunge. Okay? So in a normal situation, if I do a feint and an attack, it will look like this. Move a bit further away. Yeah, so you move backwards with the against the feint.
Yep.
Okay? So I do a feint to here. Now I do my real attack as I bring my back foot up and attack with the lunge there. So even though Valerie moved away, she's still within distance for me to hit. Let's look at that again. Feint as I bring the back foot up, lunge with the real attack. Okay? So against someone who's always running away backwards, that's how you hit them. As you make the feint, you bring the back foot up level with the front one, and then as you make the real attack, you do a full lunge. You should be able to hit them at that point. Thank you, Valerie. and I hope that's been somewhat interesting. Cheers, folks.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. We've got extra videos on Patreon, t-shirts on Spreadshirt, and I hope to see you for the next video.